Hi, and welcome to another episode of What's the Story? Here we condense things way down. My name's Chloe and I'm your narrator. I hope you like it.
It's the year 2274. The last remnants of humans live in a sealed metropolis beneath a cluster of large domes. It's a paradise managed by a computer that handles all aspects of life, including reproduction. In order to limit overpopulation, everyone must endure the carousel, a ceremony that kills them when they reach the age of 30. They're murdered under the pretense of being renewed. To track this, everyone's implanted at birth with a life clock, a crystal in the palm of their hand that changes colour as they age. It starts blinking as they near their 30th birthday. Most welcome the opportunity for rebirth or renewal, as it's referred, but those that don't attempt to escape the city, these are referred to as runners. To prevent this, an elite band of police officers known as Sandmen, dressed in grey and black uniforms, work for the city's deep sleep organisation. They're assigned to follow and kill runners as they attempt to flee. Both Logan 5 and Francis 7 are Sandmen. Logan discovers an ankh among his stuff after killing a runner, whose presence they were alerted to during renewal. Later that night, he meets Jessica 6, a young woman who also wears an ankh pendant. Logan enters the ankh into the computer, which tells him that it's a symbol for a hidden club whose members assist the runners in finding a place called Sanctuary, a fabled site where they'll be protected for the rest of their life. Logan discovers that Sandmen have lost 1,056 runners in this way. The computer directs Logan to locate and destroy Sanctuary, an operation codenamed Procedure 033. The computer instructs him to keep this secret from the other Sandmen of deep sleep. The computer uses a method known as a retrogram to shift the colour of his life clock to flashing red, bringing him 4 years closer to carousel and renewal. Fearful, he asks whether his 4 years will be returned when his task is complete, but receives no response. Logan's now forced to become a runner to escape. Logan approaches Jessica and tells her about his problem. They meet the subterranean organization, which conducts them to the city's outskirts. Logan discovers that the ankh symbol's really a key that opens up an escape route out the domed walls and into an icy cave. They encounter Box in the cave, a shiny robot made to collect food from the outside. Logan learns to his dismay that Box also apprehends runners who have escaped and freezes them for food too. Logan and Jessica manage to escape before Box can freeze them. This causes the ice cave to fall in on the robot. Once outside, Logan and Jessica discover their life clocks are not working. They're unaware that Francis is following them. Outside, they learn the remnants of human civilization have turned into a wilderness and they experience the sun for the first time. They investigate what appears to be an old deserted metropolis that previously housed Washington, D.C. They find an old man living with numerous cats in the wreckage of the US Senate chamber. They're both surprised by his looks, his lines, and grey hair, because neither of them has ever met a person over the age of 30. Logan concludes that Sanctuary has always been a myth after hearing the elderly man's recollections of what happened to humans outside the city. Logan and Francis, however, clash. As a Sandman, he is compelled to chase all runners, even those close. During a fight, Francis is badly wounded by Logan, and as he passes away, he sees that Logan's life counter is now clear and believes that he has been renewed. The old man agrees to accompany Logan and Jessica back to the city as proof that life really does and can exist outside the dome and beyond. The two re-enter the domed city and try to persuade everyone that carousel is a lie and unnecessary. After leaving the old man outside, the two are captured by Sandman and brought before the computer, where Logan is questioned and asked if his mission was successful. There is no sanctuary, Logan insists. He'd discovered old exposed ruins, an old man, and all frozen bodies of the missing runners. But even after reading Logan's mind, the computer rejects his responses. As a result, the computer overloads, causing the city's systems to crash violently, releasing the external seals. Logan, Jessica, and the rest of the population leave the destroyed city. The old man is the first person the citizens have encountered who is older than 30. This demonstrates they truly can live a long, long time and into old age and live out the remainder of their natural lives. Thanks for watching this far. I love this film. I found the plot compelling. The dystopian thing, everyone young and then to be forced to die at 30. Totally bonkers. I'm so glad everyone got outside to meet the old man at the end. I'm Chloe, and I really do hope you liked this episode of What's the Story. Please like and subscribe for more, and have the best day ever.